Marvin and Nicola, who had grown up around each other, now had the task of planning their wedding.
Most of what took place in our wedding, we sat and we discussed a lot about things, even the colors, because we had several different colors that we put on the table. And almost every day, we had to go through and change the color. So even deciding on the color, which we came up with early, but it took us a while before we could find a satisfactory color. And the thing is, when we decided on the color, we came up with a color that most persons have never seen before. It's after we used that color, we started to see it popular. As a matter of fact, persons were seeing it and they were saying that it would look like a clown wedding. So to us, it was a brave step, choosing colors that we've never seen anybody using before.
And what were these unusual colors?
Burnt orange and green. And we had some amount of gold. He finalized it because I was there and I looked at the net trying to find out other marriages that had it. And it wasn't striking to me yet. But then we started going out and by purchasing like napkins and those things, putting them together, then it came alive.
And the whole thing of politics came up in that it was two political strong colors, and we were brave enough to take it on.
When it came to venue selection, what did the couple have in mind?
Maranatha SDA Church. The church is beautiful. I remember it well. We wanted a garden, but then we were looking at the weather. Would it rain? Would it be too hot? All those kind of things. And I didn't want to have that to ponder with on the day of my wedding. So we were just looking at other places, and then it dawned to me that I went to a previous wedding and it was okay. It was good at Maranatha. And so I knew the pastor, so I called him up and asked him. And so he gave us, it was in line with our budget. And so we knew the church and it was economical, so we went for it. And we also had the reception there as well.
Marvin and Nicola's greatest challenge was the one that is perhaps every couple's nightmare.
The guest list. We started at what? 100?
100 and 100, over 100.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes we put on some names. Sometimes we had to take off some names. And sometimes we remember some persons that we never remember before. And so it posed a major challenge to us in that every day we had to visit the guest list. It was like the color. Whereas every day we remember, we didn't
forget certain
persons. And we had to go back and put in these persons in it.
We have persons to this day who is upset that we haven't invited them. but we had to, it's not that we didn't, we couldn't afford to allow so many persons to be there. And what we did though, we had a cake. So we, after the wedding and stuff, we would give cake to these persons.
Cake for friends you aren't able to invite. Sounds like a good idea. We found a company where you can find many good ideas to make your wedding spectacular. Check it out.
And my company's name is Designs by Nishi.
Nichelle was more than happy to tell us why decorations are important at weddings.
Well, decorations are important for more than one reason. The point of having decor or having, floral arrangements is to kind of be able to wow your audience. You know, for weddings, it's important in your photos. So you want to capture all these amazing shots with, the bride and groom, with your family, all in a nice atmosphere. We handle weddings, local and destination. We handle social and corporate events, and we offer gifts for all special occasions.
What should you look for in a decorator?
One of the most important things is effective communication. Being able to express your ideas to a decorator and for them to understand exactly where you are coming from. Also, if you're able to see past event photos or just ideas and concepts, drawing sketches, your decorator should be able to provide you with some form of information that will help you to visualize what is it that you're looking for. In addition to that, I would say just a decorator that's innovative, that thinks outside of the box, just able to give you something different than replicating what's seen every day.
Where a client is concerned, how does Designs by Nishi cater to your particular needs?
Well, what we do is we require all our clients to complete a questionnaire. This kind of taps into, you know, what the client's needs are, what their budget is, and what they're generally looking for, like all the different aspects of their wedding. So from that point, we take it to, you know, offering them advice on decor. We tap into the type of flowers that they're into, as well as other services that they would require.
And if you're on a budget, but still want to create a tasteful setting, here are some tips.
What I would recommend for brides that are on a budget is to evaluate exactly how much it is that you're gonna spend. Most brides want to have a large wedding and they want, you know, gorgeous flowers and they want, you know, nice backdrops, fancy chairs. But if it is that you want these things, what I would consider is to reduce the number of guests that I'm catering for. So if it is that you're looking for something very elaborate, maybe if you're catering for 50 people rather than 150, you'd be able to afford and to be able to have all these things.
Hear about unique plans for upcoming brides.
We recently started doing bridal lines just as a way for us to be able to give back to our, you know, community. So, you know, we start these bridal limes to kind of get brides more involved in what the planning process is and to offer, you know, free consultation, free makeup trials, free sessions with photographers, to be able to see gowns and, you know, that kind of thing, just to be able to help brides along the way. I mean, it's a free event. Normally, you know, bridal expos, there are charges, but we just try to make it a little bit more personalized, a smaller group at a time, and just be able to have brides sit and be comfortable in their space.
Want a close-up of what Designs by Nishi can do for you? Here are some snippets for you to savor.
Okay, this table is basically something simple that we could use for a sweetheart table. Basically, the bride and groom would sit here, and these are the centerpieces and just the table set up before glassware and cutlery and favors actually come on the table. Okay, this would be very nice for maybe an outdoor wedding. You know, because we have these potted orchids, it kind of brings out a more natural environment. So I would say this would be suitable for maybe a tropical outdoor wedding. We have these hand fans. They're really nice, especially for outdoor if it's hot. We have these at the head table and would also have for all the guests that are seated. And then these votives would help at nighttime just to create that ambiance. Okay, well, for this wedding, we actually chose fuchsia and yellow. So we try to bring all the elements together. So the flowers are actually the same thing. And because it's an outdoor tropical wedding, we're trying to bring, you know, natural colors and kind of bring out everything that nature has to offer. So we have these yellow linens, we have the yellow fans, we have pink bases for our orchids, we have fuchsia votive cloth. So it's kind of bright, bold, and it's a really huge trend for 2013. For this backdrop, it's really simple. You know, it's just fabric, different types of fabrics, different textures and colors, as well as these crystal curtains, which, you know, it gives a nice finish. And once you have like up lighting on them, they'll kind of glow and glisten. And it produces this really nice effect throughout the photos for the head table.
Chic, dynamic, elegant. Now you know where to get that perfect look for your wedding. After the break, what will Marvin and Nicola do when they have a serious argument with their bridal party the night before the wedding?